Thank you for checking out crypto.chartguys.com, the source for technical analysis in the cryptocurrency world. We are proud to announce our own crypto alert system designed to give you the most critical technical trading information possible no matter where you are. Keep your eyes on the market with mobile or email alerts for MACD crosses, RSI levels, and even inside bar alerts for dozens of coins across multiple exchanges. New features and proprietary ChartGuys indicators are already in development. Our alert system is very easy to customize and utilize, so don't hesitate to sign up for the most effective crypto trading tool on the market at crypto.chartguys.com. Hello everyone, hope you're doing well out there. We're looking at Bitcoin, Litecoin, Ethereum, and Ripple technical analysis. And before we even get to it, I can hear some of your keyboards furiously clicking away already. I don't care what your opinion on Ripple is. We are covering Ripple because you can trade it and you can profit off of it. This is a channel where we look at trading. So we're going to cover it if there's opportunity there. Another point of note, we are going to be adding the Binance alerts now. They're actually already up and running. So the Binance alerts for the volume, the abnormal volume, the volume overbought and oversold climax, and the volume breakout alert. All three of those have been added to coins on Binance. So get those clicked if you are trading on Binance. So here checking out on Bitcoin, the daily time frame, we are at our key resistance and it's a pretty big night. Keeping in mind, we are a little extended in the sense that we've gone 7 out of the last 8 days green in a row, and this major resistance level that everybody's watching is 11,775 on GDAX, slightly varies per exchange, but we're going to enter a point right now where we're either going to lose the higher low pattern on the 4-hour time frame tonight, or we're going to see a bull break of resistance. So checking in on the 4-hour time frame, here's our bull flag of consolidation. We formed a higher low at 11,411, and then we saw continuation. So that bull flag was confirmed, and now here we are forming an inside bar on the 4-hour time frame. Look at this MACD. It's just trading parallel. We don't have any clarity on this direction just yet. We need to break 11,775 to see the kind of bull reaction to get a bull cross on that 4-hour time frame. So I'm currently in a Bitcoin position. The hourly time frame, this inside bar breaking bullish, was my entry signal. So we had an equilibrium pattern here. We had our high, low, lower high, higher low, and then I saw the inside bar form within this range. So I said to myself, once this inside bar breaks and the direction that it breaks in is going to be a pretty solid precursor for which direction this equilibrium is going to break. Now, making an entry on that inside bar alone increases your risk and increases your reward a little bit. So I was fully accepting of that. And as soon as it broke, I made my entry. So I'm holding right now, looking for a break of 11,775, and I'll be targeting perhaps taking profit under 12,000 psychological resistance. It all depends on timing, what the RSI levels are on the 4-hour and hourly time frame, if we do get this bull break, and details like that. So we did consolidate here and form another higher low on the hourly time frame. I placed my stop loss below this previous higher low of 11,445. And if we get some follow through here, I will move my stop loss up to just below break even. Again, because I entered here and with the market fee for the entry, I would eat a small loss here, but perfectly acceptable with the trade that I currently have on. So 11,516 is support here, and we're looking up at resistance 11,646 and 11,775. We got within about $130 of resistance before we consolidated. So overall, this chart looks still just fine for the bulls, and we'll see if we get now an hourly equilibrium pattern playing out into tonight. But essentially, this 4-hour time frame is likely to either see a bull break in continuation or to see a bear break below 8,000 or 11,411. And now that I look at it, saying, let's say 12 hours will be tomorrow morning East Coast, we could also not see either of those happen if we do see some sideways consolidated trading over the next 12 hours. But just in terms of what's more likely than not to happen, we are likely to see a clear break before tomorrow. Checking in on Litecoin and where that puts us here. Again, still in this clear daily equilibrium pattern that's going to see a very clear break, likely tomorrow. If not tomorrow, I would say certainly on Wednesday. Check out this volume. Drew this volume downtrend line yesterday, still showing lack of volume and tightening ranges. So the 4-hour time frame, we can see that this is our lower high on the daily, and we now have a new lower high to be watching. And we also have a higher low. So we could essentially be watching this 4-hour candlestick. And just like I did on the hourly time frame for my inside bar with a little bit of an early signal, I would say how the 4-hour candlestick range here breaks is going to be a potential early signal for the daily break of the equilibrium. So if we break bullish of 214.92, it's going to be a lot more likely that we break bullish of the equilibrium on the daily. And if we break 209.20, it'll be a lot more likely to break bearish. So keep an eye on that. 4 hour inside bar currently forming here as well, with an hour and 20 minutes until it forms. Hourly chart tightening up a little higher low, some clear lower highs. But that 4 hour time frame is giving the most information, in my opinion, to be watching what we're watching tonight. And of course, the correlation to Bitcoin: if Bitcoin rejects here from resistance and pulls back to 11,000 tonight, we're going to favor a bear break. And if we see a bull break of 11,775 on Bitcoin, we will favor a bull break. So there's all kinds of little variations in this scenario as to what's going to shift the odds just a bit in terms of what is the most likely scenario to play out. So again, I'm not predicting what's going to happen. I'm saying these are things that will happen that will change the percentage chance of what reality will be in the future. So checking Ethereum. Ethereum is extremely tight on the daily time frame as well. We're trading sideways at this point, and bulls are trying to hold 836.60, and I'm looking at resistance right now on the 4 hour time frame. It's very clear. Highlighted yesterday in the live video, the lower high, lower low pattern here. We got right up to resistance this morning and could not break it. And it's just another lower high, essentially a double top, and the bulls are trying to form a higher low compared to 836.60. So we are looking at this higher low attempt. But again, I have no interest in Ethereum personally. Bitcoin and Litecoin is all I'm looking at right now, because Ethereum is so much weaker overall and there's just not really much bull momentum. So hourly time frame, weak, lower highs and lower lows, that clear bear break on the 4 hour time frame. You can see we're in a downtrend with clear lower highs. Neither Litecoin nor Bitcoin is in this kind of clear 4 hour lower high pattern. So it clearly favors the bears. So what I would do is look to play, if I were playing bullish and bearish, I'd look to play Bitcoin or Litecoin bullish if we get a bull break of Bitcoin's resistance, or if Bitcoin rejects and starts to break supports, I would look to play Ethereum bearish because it is the weakest name and will likely continue on that path. Checking in on Ripple. So Ripple had a rumor event in terms of being on CNBC tomorrow at 5 p.m. Eastern with Coinbase and the potential of, you know, announcement of Ripple getting added to Coinbase. We've heard this all before. And here is Coinbase coming back out again and saying, nope, not happening. There was a tweet by Coinbase saying, we're not adding any coins anytime soon. And that's pretty much the second time now that they are directly responding to Ripple running up and everybody talking about Ripple getting added to Coinbase. So this was setting up for a very easy sell the news event tomorrow. And I'm kind of bummed that it, you know, Coinbase went and sucked all the hype out of that hot air balloon at this point, because it was going to be a very, very easy bearish trade. If we ran up into tomorrow at 5 p.m. Eastern and didn't get the announcement, we're going to absolutely see a pretty hard sell-off. So instead, we're seeing that sell-off today. All that bull momentum being erased because it was hype and rumor. So the 4 hour time frame getting real ugly here, giving back all those gains. The hourly time frame was a clear equilibrium bear break, and that was the signal to go bearish or take profit. Where we had our high, our low of the pullback was 103.4. Then we had a lower high and a lower low, but I'd essentially call that a double bottom. Because it was so close, 103.4 and 103.2, essentially. So 0.2 of a penny difference there. So let's call that a double bottom. Then we see inside bar, hourly inside bar, hourly inside bar, bear break. There's your sell signal right there. And here's the follow through for 5 hours later. So inside bar breaking bear at 103.9 could have been the signal, or when the double bottom of 103 was a more convincing bear break. Either way, at this point, that trade would be up about 8% in just 5 hours. A very clear bear signal. And it also got, of course, the momentum follow through with that Coinbase news and causing all these people to sell. So there will be a nice opportunity to buy here, in my opinion, because we will see a bounce heading into that segment. It's going to be broadcast all over the 15-minute RSI. You can see how extreme oversold we're getting here because this is a news-related event. We haven't seen Bitcoin's RSI get anywhere near this on the 15-minute time frame in its daily uptrend recently. But here's Ripple getting crushed down to 15-minute RSI 20. And if the hourly RSI gets oversold with the 15-minute RSI getting oversold, I'd potentially be looking for, you know, a small position, or depending on, you know, how you want to play it, but looking for a bounce heading into tomorrow. It's the kind of scenario, though, where I'm going to be picky and I'm going to wait for the trade to come to me, and this RSI level has to get oversold on the hourly for me to be comfortable to be looking for a bounce. And if it doesn't, I can be perfectly fine passing up that trade and saying, oh, well, it didn't meet my criteria. I'm not going to go chasing it, trying to get this bounce, and I'll move on to find the next play. So that's where we stand heading into tomorrow. Again, 15-minute lower highs, very clear resistance levels, looking at 9.7 and 977 as two resistances just recently, and we'll be watching for a bounce overnight on Ripple, ideally from hourly oversold conditions. So it's all about Bitcoin for me, watching to see if we break this resistance or if we lose the hourly higher low support, which will then favor consolidation overnight rather than a bull break. I appreciate you watching. We'll check back in tomorrow and see how it all plays out. Thanks again. Do good things. Something else.